Yeah. Right. And just to encourage the parents too, that you're going to win your children with love. Mm-hmm. You have to, something that, where we, a ministry we were involved in years back, that our leader used to say is love them to life. Yeah. And, you know, lots of you hear the word love to death. I love you to death. But love them to life. Love your children to life. Mm-hmm. Shower them with love, not things, but with love, the same love that God showed us, the same forgiveness that God showed us. And I'm not going to get off tangent here, but I think about a lot how we parent our children. Mm-hmm. And a lot of times I have to kind of check myself because sometimes I'm like, am I as forgiving to them as God is to me? Mm-hmm. Meaning when your child messes up or makes a mistake or goes out beyond the boundaries that have been set, a lot of times we're so quick to come down with the thunders. Right. Wrath of parenting and say, you messed up. You know, I told you. Mm-hmm. And we just want to just condemn them and judge them. But we have to bring them. Yes. Correction has to be there, but you have to put that love in there. You have to love your children to life. And that's what's going to bring them back to God, because that's what God does with us. And many times I look at myself because I'm like, man, if God was the way with me that I'm with my children, I probably wouldn't want to come to God either. But because God loves me so much, I can screw up. But no matter how bad I screw up, just like the prodigal son, when I come back to God, he's right there with his arms open wide and says, no, you're not going to be a servant. You're my son. And that's what we need as parents. You have to shower them with love. Don't just hit them upside the head with the book, but pour love upon them.
You're talking about setting, some people have structures and, you know, laws and rules. But you see, the best way, I believe, from my experience, you know, and from the Word of God, like we were emphasizing on the Word of God, is that if they learn the Word of God and learn to have the fear of God, even when they are not in your home, you see, if they have internalized it, the rule, that rule is of the Word of God is more powerful in keeping them, you know, checking their heart, than the rules that you set. You know, you trying to be a watchdog, you know, when they're out of your sight, definitely they're going to push that boundary.
It all goes back to decisions and choices. The choices that we make as adults and young people, that is very important.
Yes.
We as parents, we as youth leaders can do all the teaching and instructing that we want. And these kids know the Word of God, but it's up to them to choose to follow the Word of God. Stand on it.
Yes, and something she said earlier, talking about choices and decisions, is you have to submit. We love to quote the scripture, resist the devil and he will flee from you, but we leave out the beginning of that, which says, submit yourself therefore unto God.
Yes.
Then it says, resist the devil and he will flee from you. So he's not going to flee unless you are submitted. And that word submit, it simply means to disown. When you have a relationship with God, and we're talking about these boundaries, we're talking about once they get outside the home, if they're submitted to God, that means that they have disowned. They have said, you know what? I own my life, but I disown it, and I give that ownership over to God.
Yes.
Not over to the youth minister, not over to mom and dad, not over to the pastor, but I disown. So then, therefore, whatever God, whatever you desire from me, that's what I want to do. And that's what our young people need. They need submission. And in their lives,
submission to the Word of God.
To the Word of God.
Authority of the Word of God.
Yes.
So they're always trying to push authority, but since we know that the Word of God, the authority of the Word of God is powerful.
Yes.
Is able to get into the spirit and to the soul and bring, you know, the change.
Yes.
Then wherever they go, if that is there.
Yes.
That's who they're gonna, you know.
Right.
Yes.
Walk with.
Yes.
That's who's gonna guide them.
Yes.
How can a young person stay pure? By obeying your word? I have tried hard to find you. Don't let me wander from your commands. I have hidden your word in my heart that I might not sin against you.
But I know Psalm 37:4 says, delight yourself in the word of God.
And he will give you the desires
of your heart. And when we grew up, I thought that meant that whatever I desired, he would give it to me. But that's not what it's saying. What it's saying is, if you delight yourself in the word, God will literally give you the desires, the right desires. So you as a young man or a young woman, you may have the wrong desires, the filthy desires, unclean desires. God says, if you delight yourself in the word of God, he says, I'll take away those desires, the desires you had that were tearing you down and pulling your spirit down and bringing a dark side into your life. And I will give you the desires of your heart.
Right.
So we have to delight ourselves in his word.
Desire for God, to please God.
Yes. Right. Yes.
Right. Well, Dorion, is the, I just want us to wrap this up.
Okay.
It's been quite interesting, you know.
Thank you.
Having a time of sharing.
Yes, yes. Praise God.
I want us to, you know, kind of, again, going back to the anniversary, the 15th anniversary of Water of Life, where I met you guys and where I decided you guys have to come on this show.
Praise God.
You led one of the session of worship and you kind of paused and shared a personal testimony of how God, you know, intervened in your finances.
Praise God.
Want us to pause, you know, and take a look at Dorion's, you know, testimony. And I believe if it impacted me, it's going to impact you.
We went to H&R Block. I gave the longer version this morning. We went to H&R Block. We sat with the lady and she looked at us and printed out the sheet and said, you guys owe the IRS $33,000. Owe them 33. Now this was after a previous year ago or so, we were kind of messed over by a company that we were referred to and just messed up all our taxes and everything. We had already sent the IRS thousands and thousands of dollars. And now we come back thinking, of course we got everything in order now. And then she prints the thing out saying, you owe $33,000. But glory be to God, how God works things out. And it wasn't me, it was only him.
Yes.
And the Lord just kept showing me this paper. I kept looking at it and saying, something's wrong here. And emailed the lady and talked to her and met with her and sat down. And after everything was said and done, God brought that $33,000 down to zero. And we sang a song, you can't tell it, let me tell it. Now, I'm looking kind of cool and calm saying it right now, but y'all better know that to God be the glory. Now, the one thing I didn't share this morning that I want to share with the 11 o'clock service is this. Is that God turned that thing around, but even after that, there was still something that I had to do.
That's right.
Meaning they told me, okay, you'll be down to zero, but you have to do A, B, C, and D. I'm sharing that with you today because God has blessed so many of us, but many times we don't do what God told us to do. So we miss out on our blessings. We are supposed to enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. You don't have to worry about your situation. Yeah, I wish some of y'all were sitting at the desk with me where she said, you owe the IRS $33,000. So we could look at each other. But I'm telling you, to my God be the glory. And because he has been that good to me, I have made a decision. I'm going to be sold out for Christ.
That was powerful.
Praise God. And, glory to God.
He's going to really encourage a lot of people.
Yes.
And like I said, we're going to wrap this up.